All right. Oh, did I? S I think I accidentally ended the music I was listening to. Whoops. Oh, that's why, because I was checking something. Ah, that's why I had it down so low. Perfect. Because it was very loud in my ears, so I had to turn down my music, and then I was like testing my video, and I was like, I can't even hear myself. All right, for the VOD, I am working on a doggy, but I haven't done it in a while. I just started on my. I always start with the nose and then the eyes, which makes it look kind of weird. I did just a simple background gradient and then added some clouds and did a sketch and then did a blurry line over it because who wants to do details right from the start? Yeah. I'm gonna try using a soft brush. Normally I draw with like a really rough brush, but just trying something different. Darker. I don't really have to do the top of the eye because he's got such a hairy eyebrow, but I'll do the whole eye just for fun. Just make sure I get the shape right. Probably has brown eyes. I always make them more intense than they really are. Let's pick a brown. What doing? Yeah, I'm playing Elden. Is it too quiet? Like, I have it down because I don't like it blaring, but. There, I'll try 0.8. But it's the same volume as my voice on the mixer, so I don't wanna. Man, it looks so different on your screen than mine. Like, mine is like, it's all black, and then, huh. That's weird. I hate that too. When it's too quiet, it's more annoying. I do like the reflection. Feel like he needs a little bit more brown, though. Although apparently it's plenty brown in on my other monitor. It is so dark on my tablet. I'll just go with what I see. I can always do lighting later on my computer to make it how I saw it. Yeah, I like that. The picture's not great, so I can't see any little details. Some dogs have like kind of like wiggly irises or different colors in there, but this is just a black orb, so working with what I got. And it's a surprise, this one, so it's, I can't ask for a better photo. Let's do that, and then anyone here too. Well, let's do this on another layer so I don't mess it up. And we'll do... Oops, that's... I guess it doesn't really matter because I'll change the lighting. And a darker blue. Let's do that one. Soft. Actually, I kind of want that a bit lower. Then let's move this one. Although, like, again, his hair is going to be there. Not a big deal. Okay. Oh, shit. Did I move the wrong thing? I just hate when it selects the wrong layer. I might just end up doing normal. Hard light's not bad. I can't remember what I normally use. Yeah, just do normal, honestly. And then for good measure, noise add. Oops. Oh, he does have a light. I could keep it the same as the drawing or the reference. Yeah, it'll look better when it's all together. What's bugging me there? Thank you. just be that dark patch. From far away, it looks kind of weird. There, I like that. That'll do. Do that. Oh shit, I'm on the wrong layer again. You know what? This looks fine though. I'll just merge it down. Let's see. Well, the hard part is keeping these eyes even. This one, I don't even have a reference. It is just. Spray and pray here. I'll just make it look like an eyeball. Let's zoom in a bit. Gonna find out this doggy had green eyes or something. All right, I had that really nice blue. Draw the outline. I think that's about right, though. Where are you going? Yeah, I can't. Gotta fudge some of these details. Fake it till you make it. Steal this color. It's very gray. All right. I want that brown again. Orange. Again, I don't really have to worry about the details on these eyes as much as I am, because his hair covers them. Not sure how long I'll work on this, but I'm at least going to do the eyes. That looks so different on my other screen. Might have to. I don't know if it's. It's probably honestly my monitor settings. I probably have the gamma up so I can see at night in games or something. Oops, that's not the color I wanted. All right, that's eyebally. Let's make sure the pupils are the same size. Looks about right. All right, let's do the thing. Levels of reflection. But we're just going to use the same shape. Put some blue, a little bit bluer. Not quite. Big. That's better. And then we'll add that teal along the bottom. We'll make this a little. Should be fine. We'll soften the edge here. Here. And then that should do her. Why do I do this? This one. It's a bit brighter than the other one. I can always go back in later. All right, I'm going to merge that down. I'm happy with that. My blob dog with the intense eyes and nose. Why do I do it like this? Okay, Cooper, let's zoom out. what should I do? Normally, I just keep on with the nose. But I'm not sure I'm going to tackle it this time. I was using a soft brush, which is something I don't normally do. I think I'll keep on with the soft brush and then go in with the details after. Let's just do this on a new layer. Because I will have to erase some stuff. Just rename this one. Eyes, nose. We'll rename this one Blobby Boy. Clouds. Sky. We'll call this one Fur. Oops, Fur. This is always the hardest part. Trying to figure out where to start. He's got such a horrible, not horrible, but a lot of detail in the fur. I like the ones where they're very short hair. They're a lot easier to do. Let's just try and find where the hair goes, and then I'll fill in the details after. So his nose, let's see, he's got something like this in it. And then his chin. Okay, so he's got his mouth kind of goes here. That's its actual face. And then he's got the Kentucky Fried Chicken beard. Put that like that. And his mustache is about third, a little under a third, so it's about there. Go straight and then down. Kind of realize my stream is like super early for most people. Okay, so then he's got these crazy hairs that kind of go like this. And it goes out. But an eye width, it's about here, is fine, where I had it. I gotta erase some of these crazy lines though, from Blobby Boy, when I was sketching it. We can probably just, well, actually, let's get the ears. Eyebrows are as about as wide as his eyes. Start there. It's about, yeah, about there. And think this is the first time I've drawn this type of dog. So that's why I'm not sure how to tackle it. It's not my first long-haired dog, though. Okay, and his other ear kind of cuts into his hairy, hairy forehead here, behind his eyebrow. Looks like this ear might be too big. I might have to erase that. And that. This one looks about right, though. All right, let's go erase some stuff on Blobby Boy. I'll leave that. Let's fade this one so I don't ruin my lines. You go over here. Go back over here. Can't see me moving that window around, but all right, I think that'll bug me a little less. Oh, he is so cute. Okay, he's starting to look more like a dog. Cool. Yeah, let's stick with soft for now. I might change my mind. 'Cause I like doing light fur over a dark background. That's just kind of how I shade it. But if I'm drawing it all with soft, I might kind of lose that look. Oops, why didn't that show up? Oh, it's on eraser. Let's zoom in a bit. Let's start with the nose. I always start with the nose. Actually, this could be a bit darker. Maybe. Looks like I've already kind of colored there under the nose. I'm too distracted here. Okay, save. And there is a point where, like, I just kind of stop using the reference because it's a lot, it's too challenging, so I just kind of go with the flow, but definitely start with it. So the hair's in the right spot. This is a good size, 15, eh? Let's zoom in again. This kind of comes in. Oh, Elvin, hi. Welcome, viewer number one. How you doing? You're not sorry. Doing good. Just felt like drawn a little bit this morning. Going a little overboard here, though. This dog has way too many details. Did the nose and the eyes. And then I kind of did a outline. And then my plan is to kind of fade into something more painterly in the bottom, but I haven't gotten that far yet. Starting with the nose. Nose hairs. Normally, I can just use, like, on a short-haired dog or cat. It's just, I have a brush for that. And it's like, where is it? I don't think it's paint fur. It's a directional hair. No, that's not the one. Yeah, this is the one. Oops. I can just kind of do this. And I'm done. But didn't luck out with this guy. I could probably use it like around here and get away with it. My volume. Well, I had Arc check it. Oh, I see, I see. I love you, love you. How do I get up there? There. Now she knows I love her. Anyway, back to the hard brush. This is too bright. Come up with my own colors. Might see if I have a better brush for this. Nope. I gotta stay on target. I'm gonna try soft first. I just gotta stop doing all these little fine details. And then go in with a sharper brush. I love that little guy. I'm not sure. We'll see. Have a fun appointment. That cat's being so needy. Mostly just wanted to get this idea out of my head, but I wasn't planning on like finishing this today or anything, so not sure how much longer I'm gonna stream this bad boy. Actually, I kind of like the pinky color here. I'm gonna see if I can steal some of that. The nose. And I can cover up the eyes and nose because I can erase it. Wait, this is too dark. So I'm just gonna. A little bit here. Looks like his beard is this rose gold color too. I'll just, oops, that's too big. Oh, I could do a trick. I could do a trick with this. Let's see. And then get a little bit of white on the tips. Can erase some of these. Let's see, where's this mouth actually start? Right about there. Go like that. Could do like all those little hairs like that. I wonder what that would look like. Like if I. Probably a little. Not quite what I'm going for. Mean, it looks neat though. I'll just stick with the hand drawn. Well, I mean, it's still hand drawn. Looks like the body is white here. Just Let's steal this pinky color, although I think it's lighter now, so just go a little bit lighter. Is that good? Kind of like that. Think it needs to be a little more peachy. Yeah. Let's see, do I want that gold in there? Looks like I've already got some of the white. It should be goodish before I go in with details, anyway. Zoom out. Okay. Yeah, it looks like a dog. Let's. I like made his shoulder really white. He's got a hole in his shoulder. You know what? I'm gonna do something for my own amusement here. Anyway, let's go up to here. So now this part I think I'm going to stick with the big brush still, and then I'll do the detail brush on a separate layer. God, he's got so much hair. He needs a reddish color. Maybe brown? This is all low detail. Should be good. And then his cheeks aren't. He's only got the one puff here. I don't even know why I'm doing it this way. 'Cause I can, I guess. I'll have to find out what the end result's any better or not. Doing a fuzzy layer first. I think it helps me map it out. He's got quite a bit of hair over here, but can't really see it because it's against the sky. Again, I have to calm down with the details. I'm not on that layer yet. I'm a weirdo that likes to start with details, though, so. It's because this part of the drawing always looks weird while I figure out how I want to tackle it. Cat. No, we didn't lock the cat in. She just ran upstairs and started meowing. Yeah, she tends to lock herself in. She just wants us to go lay down. And I'm like, you have a strong point, kitty. And let's get that pinky color in there. This one. Think about that. And then some blue. Something like that. We'll put some blue, some darker blue. Hey, darker blue. Goodness, this is such a hairy beast. I bet this will take me at least double the time it normally takes me to draw something just because of how much detail he has. All right, let's take some of this pink. It's more of a, purple. And some, let's make this more of a Some nice yellow. I like that color. Get his forehead here. Very, so it's kind of like on the tips of all of them. So let's go with them. A median color like that. Kind of like, can't say seashells. Nice burp pun. Oh no, she makes such a strong case. She's like, "Don't you guys want to go to bed and watch anime?" And I'm like, I haven't had breakfast yet. That's something else I gotta do. Yes. All right. Well, this is a decent stopping point anyway. I got like all the blurry details down, the colors I want to use. For the most part, this isn't quite like it's not perfect, but I can do color corrections later. I used blue instead of purple in the fur here. Just throw some more purple in there for fun. Because I like to. Something like that. All right. He looks so happy. Yeah, that's a start. I did pretty good. I don't know how long I've been streaming. But this is. It says live an hour. Okay, so this is probably an hour and a half of work. Which is pretty good. Yeah, I'm happy with that. And then I can come in with my sharp brush and start doing all those little tiny details, and I think it'll come together very quickly. And then I'll erase the cute little arms. Val says hi. Yeah, I can't. I guess I can kind of make this big. Oh, whoa, what did I do? What am I continuing to do? I am a professional streamer. Okay. Did I fix it? I was trying to make this little one bigger. There we go. So I was trying to like show off this dog. Because he's pretty small. I keep the reference thing pretty small so it doesn't cover up what I'm working on. But yeah, thank you for coming in and saying hi. It always makes me happy. I was like, I started streaming too early. No one's gonna come say hi. But I'm gonna go eat brekkie and play video games and do chores and stuff. So, yeah. Thank you.